this, we are influencing an electric potential. Charged ions moves towards respective electrodes through ions and selective membranes. Charged ions move towards respective electrodes through ions and selective membranes. Under the influence of an electric potential across a salt water solution, charged ions moves towards respective electrodes through ions and selective membranes. In the general observation, cations are attracted by cathodes, anions are attracted by anodes. This is a basic thing. So in the electrodialysis, we are influencing electric potential across the salt water solution. So whatever the charged ions, positive or negative ions, move towards respective electrodes like this. I will explain. So this is cathode. Cations are attracting because cathode having negative charge, hence cations are attracting towards cathode. Anode having positive charge, anions are attracting towards anode. The membrane are cations or anion selective, which basically means that either positive ions or negative ions will flow through cation selective membrane consisting of sulfated polystyrene, which allows only cations to flow through and reject anions. Cation selective membrane consisting of sulfated polystyrene. Cation selective membrane consisting of sulfated polystyrene, which allows only cations, which doesn't allow anions. Anion selective membrane consists of polystyrene with quaternary ammonia. Quaternary ammonia. What about cations? Same polystyrene, but sulfated polystyrene. Cation selective membrane is sulfated polystyrene. Anion selective membrane is quaternary ammonia. Polystyrene with quaternary ammonia. So understand, both the membranes are here. One is cation selective membrane, another one is anion selective membrane, which consists of polystyrene with quaternary ammonia, which allows only anions and rejects cations. Multiple membranes alternatively allow cation or anion to flow through. Hence, with this method, we can get fresh water from saline water. See here, this is the cation selective membrane. This is the anion selective membrane, cation selective membrane, anion selective membrane, cation, anion. Alternatively, cation and anion selective membranes are here. Cation selective membrane flow, attracts cathodes. These are attracted by cathodes. Anion selective membrane attracts anodes. Here we have sea water, salt water at pressure of 5 to 6 kg per meter square. Pressure of 5 to 6 kg per meter square. So cations are attracted by cathode, anions are attracted by anode. Finally, we are getting pure water from here and here. Pure water from here. Why it is coming? The process is carried out in a special type of cell called electrodialysis cell. Actually, whenever any person kidneys are not working, he is undergone dialysis like that. That is very familiar. Those kidneys are spoiled or damaged or diseased, whatever it may be, removed. For them, purification of blood and then entire body fluids, dialysis will do. Like that, here also we are for removing. So in the dialysis, what it will do in the dialysis, salts will be removed. In our body, urea, uric acid like that will be removed. But in salt water, sodium chloride salts will be removed. So this electrodialysis method, we are taking special type of cell. It's called electrodialysis cell. Electrodialysis cell. It consists of two electrodes and ion selective membranes. Two electrodes, one is cathode, another one is anode. The anode is placed near anion selective membrane. So where anion selective membrane is ended, at that site anode is placed here. So parallelly we are putting, cation selective membrane, alternatively cation anion selective membranes are here, but at which end anion selective membrane is there, at that site anode is there. Nearer to the anode is placed near anion selective membrane. Cathode is placed near cation selective membrane. So whatever we are taking first, alternatively cation selective membrane and anion selective membrane, one side it end with cation selective membrane, another side it end with anion selective membrane. The anion selective membrane has positively charged functional groups such as quaternary ammonium, polystyrene, therefore allows negatively charged ions only to pass through them here. Similarly, cation selective membrane having negatively charged functional groups such as RCOO- carboxylate ions. Hence, it passed positively charged ions. It passes through positively charged ions. Saline water and a pressure of around 5 to 6 kg per meter square is passed from the top of the cell and it passes between membrane pairs. It's here. This is one membrane pair. This is another membrane pair. This is like that. So saline water, sea water at pressure of 5 to 6 kg per meter square we are sending, it passes here. When the electromotive force, EMF means electromotive force. Yesterday yesterday you saw how electrolytic conduction will be measured. Electromotive force. When an electromotive force is applied across two electrodes, the cations, mainly present in that salt water is sodium plus, present in salt water, move towards cathode through cation selective membrane. And anions, chloride minus, Cl minus, move towards the anode through anion selective membrane. As a result, the concentration of ion in alternate compartments 2, 4, 6, see, 4, 6. Alternate compartments. 2, 4, 6. Decreases. As a result, the concentration of ions in alternative compartments 2, 4, 6 decreases, while it increases in the alternate compartments 1, 3, 5. Thus, water in the even number compartments becomes pure and is collected from the bottom of the cell. Similarly, water in the odd number of compartments become rich. Saltiness is rich in the saline water. It becomes concentrated saline water. It collected from the separate outlet at the bottom of the cell. See, here cations are moving towards here. Anions are moving towards here. Here also, in this fourth compartment, cations are moving towards here, passing towards here. Anions are passing towards here. In the sixth compartment also, cations are moving towards here, anions are moving towards here. Hence, 2, 4, 6 compartments are pure water, because entire ions present in that salt water is separated by concerned selective membranes, cation and anion selective membranes. Hence, compartments 2, 4, 6. See here, 6, 4, 2. So, from the bottom, special arrangement is there for these compartments 2, 4, and 6. We are getting pure water outlet. Pure water outlet. From the compartments 1, 3, 5, 7, like that, these having salt water, these having special, so like this, it will be entered. Concentrated seawater outlet. Hence, here we are getting pure water from the saline water, salt water, without salts. Entire salts, entire ions present on that water is removed through membranes. Cations are removed by cation selective membranes, anions are removed by anion selective membranes. This is the importance of electrodialysis of seawater. Same thing like that only, suppose any person kidneys are spoiled, and then dialysis will do like that with special equipment. What are the advantages? It is economical, convenient, and may be applied at room temperature too. It is most compact in size and requires only electricity for operation. We have to apply pressure and electromotive force, EMF. Here there is no maintenance charges, because only in one chamber salt water is going on, one chamber pure water is going on. Hence there is no regeneration, nothing will be happen. Highly economic. Only once we has to installed, only at 2-3 years it has to maintain. I mean, it is highly economic. Any temperature it can be worked. This is regarding electrodialysis of water. And its advantages.